Hello everyone, so today we're in Derbyshire, something different, and it's a really, really special day because we're going to see some really old mine workings. So there's Terry with me, so he's officially the Derbyshire expert. So yeah, we're going to travel through centuries and we're going to see from the very oldest mines to a few newer ones as well. So come and join us. So all this used to be a lead mine, but what happened in later years is that they mined it out for fluorspar. So the entire face of the wall of the rock there has been mined out. And in fact, Terry was just saying that if you look closely there, over there, you can still see a little outline of a coffin level breaking out into the open, and that's where they mined it out. So the entire area here would have been full of lead mine workings. It's a bit of a shame, but anyway, we're gonna go in there and find the mine. There's Terry setting up a little hand line. Gosh, that goes deep in there.
Yes.
Yeah, we're not gonna use any SRT gear for this one, but looking at that rope makes me nervous. It's really dusty in here. I can just see little specks of dust flying right into my eyes, and the whole, you know, this is just crumbling. Right, down we go. Oh God, that does look quite vertical actually. Gosh, it's proper steep there. Yeah, so this is the end of our hand line. Now we're gonna go down. Terry's down there, so it's all very cave-like, but actually it is a mine. It's because of all of that dust. But yeah, a little pool. And all these little mini workings. So are we going straight ahead there?
Yes, we're going through that bit.
Ooh, nice. Wow, in we go. This is a random little passage. Yeah, this actually reminds me a little bit in South Wales. There were these lead mines and Roman lead mines. I did a video on that as well. That's the same sort of rock. Again, really crumbly, sort of really muddy, but strong overall. Just, yeah, you know, that's a tiny little passage. You, I don't know if a human would. Yeah, I guess they would. But someone must have. That must be children working, because they clearly crawled in there, because there's pick marks there. But my God, that's tiny. Yeah, it's a mishmash of workings. Various age. Yeah, again, that's old. That's there. That's an old hand pick chamber. And right here, and actually, this is. So maybe this is fluorspar. I don't know. I can't. It's really hard to tell it apart from quartz. There's a kibble, but this is from the fluorspar era. My God, the weight of that. This one still moves, but God. I mean, it's heavy enough just being like this. I guess so. They would it swivel around that, because there's an axis either side, yeah. And then flip it. Gosh, it's heavy enough as it is. There's pick marks. Literally, you can see the course of the vein. So what they've done is they mined it out, and you can literally see where the pick marks scratched into the vein. And they just mined it all out. It's some modern machinery, and right next to it, I mean, this is just stunning. You see how long the grooves are? So they just like chiseled all the way down. I think they had a really specific technique where you would just kind of chisel down, and then get to the next one. My God, so they would be moving in something like inches a day.
Inches a day, yeah.
Jesus Christ. What a French big chops. Oh my god. Wow. Oh my god, yeah, all the entire shop. That's not small. And it's sort of square in shape. All that is hand-picked. That's madness. So where we had this coffin level, sort of breaking into, well, into the shaft then, obviously that then later got all blasted, unfortunately. But right here, Terry spotted that there's a witch mark. I'm just going to try and shine from the side there. There's a W. And essentially, people, so it's very much of a sort of medieval style thing. Would have been something like, you know, 1600s maybe, where these coffin levels were worked. I mean, we don't know exactly, but they would draw these witch marks, and they came in all sorts of, you know, some of them were round sort of circles, some of them were W's. And actually, from the history, the witch mark is not actually a W, it's actually two V's. So it wasn't exactly like a W for a witch. But yeah, I'll be very interested to see whether we can find any more. But they would draw these witch marks essentially as a sort of good luck and protection sign everywhere. Yeah, wow. So if this wasn't crazy enough, there you've got the pick marks. And all of a sudden, you've got slightly later, sort of this is now 1771. There, DTW, 1771. That sort of strange sign, and then a T, and I think they've been sort of scraped over because they look really fresh, but they are believed to be original. And 1771, this is when they would have been starting to use black powder, although they probably were still doing some hand picking here and there if the rock wasn't too hard. Yeah, this place is mental. There the tally marks. No, you can see, but how many? There's like one, two, three. It's like, I guess, 10 and then 10. Yeah. So this, again, this would have been later, I guess, the tally marks, yeah. You know, when they were working at larger scale. Back in medieval times, they'd have their little wooden kibbles, you know, removing bit by bit. What have you found there? Oh, these are perfect. Mm-hmm. Look at these ones. Oh, bless them. Wow. It's the proper thing. And they're all so spiky. Like, you wouldn't be crawling into a chamber covered in these, but my God. While I was looking at these big blobs of fluspar, Terry just pointed out that this again, where the vein went. They just hand-picked the whole thing. So really, this is not just a coffin level. This is a whole hand-picked chamber. So they just went in and over there as well, all around there. So they were just hand-picking the entire vein. That's what they used to do back in the day. So they would never drive a crosscut. All they would do is just follow the vein. And then because here clearly was really thick, I mean, that's like a few meters wide. So lots of lead. Wow, and yeah, you can see even how where it was round. So they just scraped all that they could find. Like went it right into all the nooks and crannies. Oh my god. Love that. some not so old artifacts. 1969. Fair enough. Rock there that's been folded. As it was formed, but that's really not it, because when we looked up above, so there's the vein, and so again it's sort of joined, so again there's a bit of folding action happening, but there, do you see the junction? Do you see there's like a triangle? And then inside the triangle there's crystals, there's a pocket of crystals. I mean, that's just the most beautiful thing I've ever seen in a mine. How extraordinary. Yeah, loads of tiny bits of galena there and there, a little bit there, so the old men didn't take all of it. So that's probably because this is where the older workings were taking out this fluspar. But yeah, I can't believe they left that one in. It's That's amazing.
Nice campus there.
Yeah. Is that a bit of galena again? Wow, that's a huge... Oh, you see? Oh, that's probably one of the best galena examples around. Because you can really... Yeah, and it glistens as well, so... Yeah. Oh, that's a good one. Wow. They scratched into this. Wow. But I just really like the spacing, how each pick mark is roughly the same spacing away, so they knew sort of how much to take on. And then, you know, get another layer, get a little bit more out. Yeah, there's an impressive pack wall, but really, what's more impressive is look at all these pick marks. And they, that's, do you reckon that's a hand-picked sort of like a shaft or like a connection from the chambers above? Yeah. That's a large area to hand-pick. But then there's some modern shot holes here and there. So actually, you know what? This, looking at these modern shot holes interspersed with the pick marks. So really that, so where the shot holes went, there would have been smaller galleries. So maybe this wouldn't have been just one big chamber back in the day. And you would have crawled in between. Wow. Is that the lake? I'm not quite yet. Okay. So you said this was dry in summer. Oh, certainly not dry now. Gosh, it's raining down. I wonder if it's because it's raining outside. There's a, an old little bucket. So over there, by the looks of it, there's another hand-picked shaft. Well, it's hard to tell. A, because there's loads of water coming down, and B, it's quite dusty and humid. So we were walking down there and showing these big chambers, and actually we thought maybe it's a bit misleading because, so where I was saying that, you know, there were modern drills there, this is more like what it would look like. So tiny little pockets, you know, even though that's a funny little pocket there, but you see where they've scratched out tiny little pockets there, little galleries there. And then yes, you go up and you drop down, but you know, they're not huge. Even so, even there, on the back wall there, there's still a modern shot hole there. So this thing would have been really creepy, crawly, pockety back in the olden days. So really, really very much like that over there. These crystals are amazing, by the way. Wow. Oh my God, Terry, I don't know if I'm... Do you think this is a fossil?
Yeah, it looks like one.
Oh my God, like a massive ammonite, but this is huge. I'll just show sort of a scale. That, you know, this big squiggle, so ammonites, they're called. That's huge. Someone must have taken it.
Yeah.
Someone had a nice find and thought, even just in the modern, you know, fluorspar days, yes. You know, it could have been 50s, 60s or whatever, they thought, oh wow. It's a nice find. It's not uncommon, but yeah. So now we're gonna go through the cave bit and then into the other older part of mine.